Back. What is up and what is and what is popping, YouTube gang? Your fave, your girl, Maya, is back to the back. Hold on, to the back at it again with another, say it with me, video. Hold on, shamidio. Okay, and today I am bringing y'all the very long awaited, very highly anticipated, how do you get an apartment? At a young age, how do you get an apartment at 18, 19? How do you do it, Maya? How'd you do it? So I am here to give you guys all of my knowledge, of course, out of a place of very much sincerity, because I know, like, sometimes, y'all, the living situations may not be great for y'all. So I'm glad you can find me as an outlet to help y'all out on getting your first apartment. Everybody's journey, everybody's situation is different, whether that's financially, emotionally. Like, you may not be ready for this. You may really not be ready for this. So before you jump straight into this, just evaluate, can I handle independence, like serious independence, like bills are in my name independence, my credit's on the line independence. So before you get into this, just take that little, just take a little think, like, damn, am I ready for this? Because I'm going to give you guys some real knowledge, some real facts. So if you are ready, or if you're just looking, like, if you think you're ready, girl, stay, because we got a lot of stuff to talk about. So I'm so excited to get into this video. If you are new, please do not leave here without hitting my sub button and hitting my bell, because the consistency on this channel is just amazing, y'all. So I hope you guys enjoy, and I don't want to talk too long. Let's just get straight into this video. So there is so much that goes into getting your first apartment. So therefore, I broke up this into almost sections, I guess, or chapters. I don't really even know. I just broke it up into parts because I want to go into things in detail. So there's going to be a lot of videos that combat this specific video, like questions you should ask when getting your first apartment. So I may not go into depth on those specific things because there's going to be a whole other video created for that specific topic. So I got all my notes written down here. So let me see what I started off with. The planning process. The grudgeful planning process. This is the longest process of getting your apartment. I suggest, personally, just because I like to be super secure with things. If you're a person who just goes with the flow and just likes to rush into things, then this planning process is not for you. But if you are a diligent person who likes to seriously plan out things, then keep on listening. The planning process is super important in renting your first apartment. There's a lot that goes into the planning process. Personally, I started my planning process a whole year prior to getting my first apartment. Now, the first apartment I ever got wasn't my ideal apartment. There was just a couple of things wrong with it, and I'm now in my dream luxury, or whatever they want to call it, townhouse apartment. So let me just say a disclaimer, you may not get it right the first time, because I didn't, and I speak from truth. I didn't get it right the first time. I took a whole year to do this and still didn't get it right. So don't feel pressured that you have to get every single step right, because I learned a lot along the way. So my first step of the planning process was setting standards for myself. These standards can consist of various things, like, what location do I want? Do I need to be close to work? Do I need to be close to school? Do I need to be close to certain grocery stores or malls or things like that? My next thing was, what specific things am I looking for in the apartment? For me, I am a female who lives alone. Something that I will not negotiate on is I need an outside entrance. I'm not doing the whole apartment hallway thing, because it can be extremely dangerous living alone as a female. When you're going through hallways and then people start to know when you leave, when you come back, and then there can just be a lot of things that can go wrong. When you have an outside entrance, you're in the open. Everyone can see what's going on. You can't always see what's going on in a hallway. It's in an enclosed space. So I did not negotiate that I needed an outside entrance. I also didn't negotiate that I need a garage. I just bought a beautiful car and I will cry if anything happens to it. So I needed a garage to put it in. Now, your standards and my standards may be different. Build your own standards because every single person is different. While we're talking about amenities that come in the apartment, there is so many different things that apartments offer. Some apartments will offer washer and dryers in their unit. That was something that I preferred because I don't really want to have to go to like the laundry facility that they may have, or I don't want to have to purchase my own washer and dryer, or I don't really want to have to go to a laundromat. Again, that's my specific standard. If you're okay with going to a laundromat, then go for the cheaper unit that doesn't have the washer and dryer included. It's all about what you want. A lot of apartment complexes also offer things like the gym, or a pool, or a playground. Are these necessities for you, or are these extra add-ons? Make a list of necessities and add-ons. Add-ons are things that you can be lenient about. You don't need to have it, but you prefer. Necessities are things you have to have in the apartment. I had to have that outside entrance. I had to have that garage. I had to have a washer and dryer in my unit. I would like to have a balcony. I don't have to have a balcony, but I would like to have a balcony. I would like to have hardwood floors all throughout my apartment, but since I don't have a pet, it's not a need. It's just something I prefer. With my specific unit, I kind of got both. I do have vinyl hardwood all throughout my kitchen and my bathrooms, and the rest of my home is carpet. The specific community I'm living in keeps their apartments immaculate, keeps them so super clean. So I wasn't hesitant about going with the carpet because they steam cleaned it before, they do all of that prior. So study who you are purchasing from. Do they answer the phone when you call them? Do they always send you to voicemail? What's the character of the renters? Are they easily triggered? Can you ask them a question and they don't know the answer? Your landlord or whoever the company you're renting from is going to play a huge, huge role. Because say you were trying to schedule a tour and you can never get them to pick up the phone. Do you think they're going to pick up the phone when you're in an emergency situation and you need your washer fixed or you need your sink fixed? Probably not. So pay attention to little details like that when purchasing your apartment. It's so, so important to peep every little thing. This specific community is always on top of, hello, how you doing? Are you good? Like always answering their phone. So sweet, so nice. And some of the other complexes I looked at, I had to call them at least 4 or 5 times throughout the day for me to get one pickup from them. So those type of things are things you want to pay attention to because that will speak to the character of the complex you are renting from. So once you have made your standards, once you have created that list, it is now time to create another list, which is the dreaded budgeting. Wow, budgeting, money, having to spend money. Yes, it sucks, but it is a necessity when living on your own for the first time. If you go into this with no budget, just spending recklessly, you will not have enough money by the time the first comes to pay rent, and I promise you that. It is so important to budget your money. I personally use this app called Mint. This is not sponsored. I genuinely love this app. It shows you exactly how much money you spend on fast food or restaurants or groceries, and it can keep you within your budget once you set those limits. So make sure to get a budgeting app. There's so many apps out there like this. So find the one that works for you and stick to it. Personally, I am going to recommend that you have at least 6 months' rent saved up before you hop into this apartment. Please do not get an apartment if you only have 1 month's rent in a security deposit. You're not going to be set up for success. That is a whole setup for failure. Make sure you are able. Do not jump into something you are not able to do because you will crash and burn. I'm speaking from the heart because I don't want you guys just to jump into something just because you think you're ready. You may think that, but look at the facts. Look at how much revenue you are bringing in on a monthly basis. Is this enough to support you? Because again, it's you, only you. Unless, let's get into the next section, roommates. Roommates. Okay, again, personal preference. I personally could never do a roommate. I just couldn't do it. I don't know. It's just me. I'm weird, okay? I like my own space. I like everything that I put somewhere to not be moved. I don't want to deal with the drama of a roommate. But again, if you are in a situation where you need to get out ASAP and the only option is to have a roommate, then get that roommate, please. Please don't stay in that toxic household. Find that roommate, please. So, roommates, let's talk a little bit about what this comes with. So, with a roommate, the benefits are you guys can actually combine your income while applying. Some apartment complexes will require you to make, I'm just gonna say a random thing, 3 times the amount of rent. And you may not make that alone, but that's okay because if you have a roommate, you guys can combine your income and actually submit that as your income and you'll get approved. But, let's talk about the other things that come with roommates. You have to understand that you are living with somebody else, and this person may not be somebody that you really know. A lot of roommates are just found online or found, however, via common persons or however you guys met. Understand that your space may be invaded at times, and you have to be okay with that. You have to be okay with sharing your space. You may be coming from a household that had a whole bunch of people in it, and you're fine. Like, okay, I've lived with people my whole life. But are you ready to live with someone who is not considered family? You may be moving in with a family member, and that's great because you're used to that person. But if your roommate is someone you're just meeting, make sure to watch them for a few months. Really develop a friendship and relationship before hopping into moving into a whole apartment with them. Because child, when it comes time to pay rent, if they have an unreliable personality, what makes you think that they're going to be reliable for bringing the bread on the first? If they have an unreliable personality, what makes you think that they're going to split the grocery bill? Look at all of these things before committing yourself to a roommate, because it will cause you a lot of unnecessary stress if you were to just sit back and analyze them before committing to it. I've seen so many videos on TikTok of roommates going like crazy on the other roommate, whether it's due to not paying the bills or not pitching in for the food or just stupid stuff like that, or moving out and leaving them with the place. All those things factor into roommates. So be okay with that and make sure the person that you are going to be rooming with is super reliable. For me, they'd have to be clean, just because I'm a clean freak, but I don't know for you guys. So if they're not clean, that's just a no, like no. But all those things are things you want to look into when dealing with a roommate. So after you figure out what your standards are and how you are going to pay for the rent, it is now time for your apartment search. I started looking at apartments, that's going online, scheduling tours, 3 months in advance of me actually getting the apartment. And let me tell you why I think 3 months is the best decision. 3 months gives you enough time to really take your time looking at all these apartments, everything they offer, the communities, and really getting a feel for how they are. Okay, so the apartment search. Once you figure out, okay, I'm having my roommate, this is how I'm going to pay for it, now you need to look for apartments within your budget. If you know you cannot afford a certain apartment, don't go look at it. Because you might fall in love with it and then convince yourself you can do it when realistically you can't. Do not look at apartments above your budget. You will set yourself up for failure, okay? Just listen to me, I promise you, okay? I will personally tell you guys my rent because I want to be super, super open with you guys. I pay about $1,700 of rent a month. That is an extremely high price for somebody who is just going into getting their first apartment. But because I have the means, I was able to do it. If you do not have the means, please do not go out and rent a $2,000 apartment. It will crash and burn. It will crash and burn. I personally would recommend if you're having an apartment alone, look for a studio apartment. A studio does not have a dedicated bedroom. It's kind of more of like an open layout apartment, but it is going to be cheaper. I would look at one for about, they really have them for, depending on your area, $400 through $500, $600. That's a good range to stay in if you are getting a studio and you are going to be staying alone. If you have a roommate, you guys are obviously going to need a 2-bedroom. 2 bedrooms are expensive. I currently have a 2-bedroom and trust me, they're expensive. So with a 2-bedroom, if you do have your roommate, you guys are obviously going to split the rent. If you're staying within that $800 through $1,100 range, you should be pretty good because you're going to have to cough up probably about $400 or $500 for rent. So you always want to get more for your money. So while you're on your apartment search, there's always gonna be like, if you scroll down, it will say utilities and what's included. Personally, my home offers all my utilities covered, which is probably why the rent is so high. So with that, if you are looking at a place that has all their utilities covered and the rent is still pretty okay, that is bang for your buck. Because let me tell you, the utilities is what might take you out. You might have all your rent money good for the first, but then you forget, oh, I got utilities to pay for too. So I would recommend, as an 18, 19 year old who's just getting used to, you know, the whole adulting thing and being independent, try to find a place that has at least most of their utilities covered. A lot of companies will do like the heating and water included, and then they might just make you pay for your electric, but some companies will do everything. So look for companies that are going to cover your utilities, because you'll end up getting more for your money. Because say you get an apartment for $800, but then you end up spending $300 on utilities. You're at the $1,100 range, where you can get an apartment for $1,000 that has all the utilities covered. You're getting more for your money, sis. Okay? Food for thought. So once you go through all these things, once you see which apartments match up with your list of your standards, it is now time to schedule tours. I would recommend looking at least 4 apartments before you make any decisions. And let me tell you something, look at them during the day and the night. See what the difference is between those two, because a lot of places, child, the nighttime be gets how, and you think it's a good place, then you see in the night and you're like, why did I ever sign that lease? So make sure you are looking at those things. When you're on these tours, ask so many questions, okay? I'm gonna make a whole different video on what questions you should ask while apartment touring, because there is a lot of them. Also, ask some of the people there, hey, do you guys like this place? How long have you been living here? What is it like? When you get those authentic reviews from people, child, it really might make or break that deal. Also, online reviews. If something repeatedly keeps on coming up and keeps on coming up, like maintenance never answers me, there's an insect problem, that is going to show you that that's probably true. I mean, if 10 or 15 people are saying the same exact thing, trust your gut, child, it's probably true. Also, when you're living in apartments, insects can be a problem. You're living right next to people and they may not be as clean as you. A lot of apartments do offer pest control services, but make sure you're keeping your space clean, just because insects, especially in the South, roaches are real. And child, they're very, very disgusting. So make sure you're keeping your space as clean as you can, and make sure you're on top of your pest control, because I've seen some reviews on some places. Oh no, just make sure you're reading all the reviews, please, and listen to them when they keep telling you something over and over again. So once you have gone on this tour, you're then going to decide between these 4 or 5 or however many apartments you went to see. You're gonna go ahead and make your pros and cons list on all of them, you know, drawing conclusions for each apartment, marking them off or keeping them in the last round. I was stuck between 2 apartments by the end of this whole process. And once I truly prayed on it, if you are spiritual, child, you better get to praying, because God has the answer for you. So once I got to these last 2 and I could not make a decision, I prayed on it and God brought me to the place that I am at now. Once you have come to a conclusion, it is now time to apply for your apartment. Make sure the one that you have chose is something that you will actually get accepted into, because the filing fees can be pretty expensive. For the specific place I'm at, it was $450 just to apply. So keep that in consideration when you are drawing your conclusion. How much is my security deposit going to be? How much is my admission fee gonna be? How much is the filing fee? There's so many fees that they hit you with. So make sure, child, make sure you are staying tuned. Stay woke, because they will get you. By the time you end up filling that application, you'll be like, okay, $300, please. Okay, $400, please. And a lot of places that are not as expensive as this one, it's gonna be like $100 to $200. So just keep that in mind when you are coming to your conclusion. So once you go ahead and apply for your apartment, it's gonna take them, it took my place only 2 or 3 days to tell me, but that just depends on the complex you are applying to. So it can take probably up to 2 weeks for you to really know, but just trust God throughout that time. I know it can be easy to be like, oh my God, am I gonna get in? But trust God, because he will never lead you in a place that you cannot handle or that is not meant for you. So once you get accepted, you are now into your new apartment. Things are so fun. Oh my gosh, it's my new apartment. I'm 18. I got an apartment. Things may seem so great, but please make sure to stay responsible and stay disciplined. Sometimes you may not be able to go out and party because you got to pick up some extra hours at your job to get that rent money. Sometimes you may not be able to splurge on that shopping spree because you got to pay for your electric. These things do come with getting an apartment. So it's not all amazing. There is a lot of discipline. There's sometimes maybe some tears when you can't come together with the rent money, but just know God has got your back. I hope this helps somebody out who is looking to apply for their first apartment at a young age or at any age in general, because all these are applicable to any ages. Thank you so much for tuning in. I love you guys so much. And if you want more videos like this, don't forget to hit my bell, hit my sub button, and comment when you want to get your first apartment below. I love y'all so much, and I'll see you next video. Mwah. Bye.